In this video, you'll see how Huygens' principle can explain almost everything in waves. If you have a light wave emitted like this one from the book and examining these points here, these points can be thought of as individual waves that moves with the same initial speed as the first wave. Let's rewind and see how. These subs waves will tell where the wavefront is in some time later. Keep in mind, this happens on infinitely many points. Here is shown a few more waves. But wait, what about the waves going backwards? Well, we'll just use Huygens' principle to predict where the new wavefront is in some time later. We have several waves, but in reality, there would be infinitely many points, and of course, they would also propagate in three dimensions. Let's see how. Here, I've used 7 new wavefronts as 3D and it's already completely messed, but you can still see how they propagate and they will reveal the new wavefront. That's very cool and all, but why is this useful? Well, first of all, it's nice in situation where the source is moving. Here we see a plane and it's making sound waves instead. And just like that, we have visualized the Doppler effect and we can clearly see how a plane traveling by the speed of sound picks up and builds a shockwave. Okay, maybe strictly speaking this isn't Huygens' principle because there's no secondary wavelets. I just want to make this animation. Secondly, the principle is effective when the wave is splitting apart. It will easily show how Young's double slit experiment works. If you just draw the wave like the statement says, you'll end up with this. And lastly, it's great when the speed of propagation varies. Let's use Huygens' principle to see how refraction will make the light bend. When the sun emits rays, they are so far away from the Earth that you can say the light is a planar wave, meaning that they are spread out on a plane, and not as a sphere as we saw earlier. Now we are back on Earth and we're looking at some water below and some air on top. You can see the light from the sun can be represented by this planar wave. This wave could also represent a laser light coming from the air and soon about to hit the water. Therefore, you'll expect to see something like this. This is a laser ray going into a water bucket. The water caused the laser to refract and bend. This line would of course also obey Huygens' principle. For example, the wave is here and then each point will be thought of as individual waves and then some time later it will reveal the new wave top. It's here. So now let's use the principle to see the wave hitting the water. As expected, the light in the water moves slower. We can clearly see why the light bends in the water. Because the new wave top is here and some time later the laser going in the water will align with this new wave top and so it will go like this and bend. Notice, we can also see what path the reflected wave took. It has the same reflected angle as the incident angle. If you wanted, you could use this setup to find the law of reflection and Snell's law. That's fine for the laser, but how about the spoon? The observer saw the spoon refracted like this. Let's switch perspective to see this better, and we'll change the water so it won't refract, but only be somewhat transparent instead. Now we just run the same analysis. We'll see the light's fastest path isn't in a straight line from the eye to the spoon. Instead, the fastest line is to go inclined in the water and then straight to the eye. And light always goes for the fastest path, so this will cause the light rays to bend. Now let's use the principle to see why mirages occur. Have you ever seen some weird reflections on the road like this? This happens on hot days, so if you have two cars, you are in this car and the temperature is very hot. The sun ray hits the earth and so it's hotter close to the ground. This causes the atom to be further apart, as is shown in this video. And so the index of refraction is lower the further you go to the ground. You can see more about index of refraction in this video. I'll mark the temperature difference with this red gradient. Now let's use the principle. The lower wavelets are expanding faster because it's hotter. In reality, there would be infinitely many of these waves, but I'm just drawing a few. We see that the path was quickest if you go downwards, and light takes the quickest way, and so if you would look down on the road, you would see the car race, and see the car. Okay, so this concludes the video. It's easy to see how powerful it is to draw moving waves and secondary waves in different mediums to predict what's going to happen. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Consider subscribing or joining me on Patreon.